Hi, in this video I want to show you a very common problem with the software of DeLonghi Magnifica. So what was the problem? When you turn on the machine, the indicators here on this panel start to flash one by one continuously, and you cannot turn on the machine or push the coffees, nothing happened, only these indicators here flashing continuously. So this is the problem with the electronics. What we have to do is to delete the software of the electronics and upload the new software without any problems. And this actually make the machine work perfectly. But what caused this problem with the software? So you have to make maintenance on your machine, maybe every 1 or 2 months. I will show you what to do to prevent this, because if you have a problem with the electronics, most of the time you have to buy a new electronic board, and it's very expensive, and you have to throw away the machine. So what was the problem when these indicators here start to flash? You have a problem with your brew group, or you have problem with the transmission that move the brew group up and down on the machine, inside the machine. So if you don't clean the machine how I will show you, you have to do it. So first we have to remove the drip tray, of course, and you can see the brew group. We have to clean and replace the o-ring inside the brew group, and of course we have to clean inside the machine. But first we will clean the brew group. So let me show you what I'm using. These are the o-rings that are inside. You need two, but they sell 10 in the package. I need two here and one on the boiler. I will show you later. So first we need to, you can see how hard it is for me to push the piston. So this will destroy the transmission. You will have a problem with the electronics, and you want to prevent this, only have to clean the brew group. So you can see we need to remove this plastic here. This goes here, and we have to push the piston out. You can see these are the two o-rings. See how this o-ring expand and start to roll, and this cause a very big friction and a problem with the electronics. You can see this o-ring here, it start to roll, and it's have to be replaced. The top o-ring is better, but you can see it's like it's not good. So we remove the o-rings. We have to remove the metal screen. You need a Phillips screwdriver, and don't lose this screw. This is stainless steel screw, and you need to be sure the same is go here. So as you can see, this is coffee here, and we have to clean it. Here also we will remove this valve here. and this actually make the foam of your coffee. So first we're gonna use a cleaning chemical, and again I will show you what I'm using. It's for coffee and milk. I make a solution here and spray it. So let me show you here. I use a toothbrush and I will leave it like this. Now we need to take out this here. What I'm using is this knife, and we have to, it's not locked, but you need to from one side, from the other side. You can see how much, see, from here, and it's going out. See, this is black, and now I'm going to spray it and it will be transparent yellow, the color of this. You see the spring here, how much coffee is here and here inside. So now I'm going to spray like this, and I'm going to leave it for a moment. And if you have rubber gloves, you can use, because the chemical is strong and I can feel it on my skin. But we're going to do the same here. We're going to leave it for a moment. And now this, we don't need to disassemble more of this the brew group. You can remove the front, but you don't need to do it, because these parts here are important. You can clean, of course, here, right? I'm not going to do it because it will take a lot of time. So now we're going to start with the metal screen. Of course, you can see how clean it is. And you can see the light, the hose, you can see it. So this is okay. I will start with the small things. You can see the actual color of this plastic here. Again, I'm not going to waste your time. You can see the yellow color. This also going to be yellow. But yes, you can see yellow. Now the piston. Of course, you can do it in the sink. And of course, the first two or three coffees you don't drink. So now the spring goes down and the plastic yellow valve is up. And then the plug. You push it. Okay. Now the screen and the screw. Now I'm going to use this to remove the moisture. Now we put two new O-rings. Again, you can see here is a little bit of dirt, but you can take more time. And you can see, compared to new to old. So now I'm going to use this lubricant because it has to be for the food grade lubricant. It's clever. It's Seiko use this on their coffee machine, so I'm using the same on the DeLonghi. Now we make it not much. You don't need much, but okay. And here you can see where the plastic start to wear. We're going to, so now this is okay. I'm going to use a little bit more. It's too much here inside in the cylinder. Again, you can clean it with water. Now I'm taking the piston. Let me see. Come on. Yes. It's so easy to move now. And this is how it should be. You can clean also here. Like this. And the last is this plastic clip here. And now the brew group is clean and ready for use for maybe 1 or 2 years. It depends how many coffees you make every day. If it's in home use, maybe you can use it 2 years with these O-rings. If you use it in the office, maybe 1 year or less. It depends how much coffee makes. So after we clean the brew group, we will remove this support here. We're going to clean inside the machine all coffee debris. So you need torque is number 25. We're going to remove the support for the brew group. It's 2 bolts here. So now, let me remove the bolts. You can see how much coffee is here, inside. And something very important. This here is a drain channel and need to be clean. You can see how much coffee is here. So here is the same. I'm going to leave it for the moment in the water. So now we remove the support. I will leave it in the water for a minute, and I'm going to use normal lubricant for everything, and I will lubricate here this metal piece here. This actually move up and down the brew group and need to be lubricated as much as you can. Put here. So it need lubrication. And it's not have a contact with the coffee, so it could be a normal lubricant. So now, let me see. It's a lot of coffee. Okay. Let me. I'm going to spray with chemical. Definitely use rubber gloves because I feel the chemical on my skin. It's not nice. So again, I'm not going to make it 100% clean because it will take a lot of time. Let me make it dry. So what we're going to do is put a little bit more lubricant and we're going to be ready for use. This will make your machine make better coffee and you will prevent a lot of problems. Again, first we need to remove. You can use your vacuum cleaner to remove the coffees here, or brush. So now I'm going to apply here, not too much, because on these two pieces here and here, when the support moves. Okay. So now, before I put the support inside, I want to show you this orange here. You squeeze a little bit and remove this O-ring. You can see the yellow plastic. If you see water inside, is a problem. You have O-rings inside this plastic that it's failed and you have to replace it. But you know how to replace this O-ring here. You put lubricant here. Now, for the moment, just let me, because I want to make, I will replace it. But so now here is the support. Yes, we return the screws. This and the other one, and this will prevent a lot of problems with your coffee machine. We have the clean brew group, of course, and now we going to clean here a little bit, and now, of course, we can test the machine. And something interesting, you can see it's working perfectly. Let me see. We need a little bit of coffee. Heating up the machine, and here. you can see water coming from the steam valve. I have to replace the steam valve because here inside there is O-rings and they are a problem. So I will replace the steam valve. So now we can make coffee. The steam valve. And now the brew group moves effortlessly inside the machine, and this will not cause problem with your coffee machine. Of course, you can see the drips from here. I have to replace the steam valve. But this is how to clean 100% your machine and make a good maintenance that will assure that machine will work very long time. Bye.